Contango can be one of the more difficult to comprehend ideas when we talk about futures markets. But it's really because it's used in different contexts all the time with slightly different meanings depending on whether you're talking about someone participating in a futures market or whether an academic is talking about it. But first, let me give you the proper definition. So the proper definition of contango, it's actually a theory. It's actually a theory, and it really can't be. It really can't be observed. And contango theory says that people are willing to pay more to buy some commodity in the future than the actual expected price of that commodity. So when we talk about expected price, this is a very theoretical thing. If you were to go and survey everyone participating in the futures market and say, what price do you think silver will be in 8 months? And if they all, you know, you took your survey and they all told you the 100% honest answer, you could get this theoretical expected price. And maybe that theoretical expected price is $33. So this right here is the expected price of silver in the market. And you could see from this futures curve right here that the silver futures contract for delivery, for delivery 8 months from now is trading above that. It's trading above the expected price. And it's probably trading above the expected price because people who want to have silver in 8 months, they don't want to buy it today and have to go rent some space and store the silver and have to insure the silver and worry about someone maybe stealing the silver. They'd rather just pay for a premium in order for it to have it be delivered in the future. So this is kind of the correct academic definition of contango theory, the theory that the futures price on a future delivery date is going to be higher than what the market actually expects. So people to some degree are paying a premium to have the delivery of the silver, to have it delayed. Now in practice, you will hear people say that a market is in contango. And usually what they're talking about, they're usually talking about one of two things, and they're related. But usually if they're a little bit more correct about it, they're talking about the idea that the futures price is over time going to converge downward to the actual spot price. So what I've done here, so this is the futures curve. So this is just the price, the delivery price of the different contracts going forward in time. But this is the delivery price, the market delivery price today, right now. This is how things trend over time. So in magenta, I have the spot price trending over time, right over there. And then you can see that you have the four-month, the contract that's for delivery in 4 months today, its price is a little bit under $35. But as you approach its actual delivery date, so now we're actually moving forward in time, it has to converge to the spot price. Otherwise, people could make free money on that day. And so the delivery date 8 months out has to converge to the spot price eventually. And so what you see is because the spot price hasn't moved up a lot, and you see this downward converging of the different futures price, this is what people normally refer to when they say a market is in contango. When you see the delivery price of a certain futures contract converge downward to the actual spot price. All of these are converging downward over time. So it's something that you would have to observe over time, not something that you would traditionally just be able to look at a futures curve. But in general, when you have this, you normally see that the futures delivery prices are higher the further out you go. So you have this upward sloping futures curve. So the simplest kind of analysis when people say something is in contango, they'll just look at an upward sloping futures curve or a normal curve and they'll say, this is also in contango. But this isn't exactly right. It's really these movements over time.